I put up on the screen a little earlier the report Fortune Favors the Brave, some specific challenges and things. And one of the outcomes from both that work and a Seeing is Believing visit that was led up in the north was the Water Task Force. What is that?
Well, it's really exciting. It's the fact that businesses have got together to recognize some of the real challenges we have in this country as well as globally around water. I mean, for us as a company, Anglian Water sits in the most water-scarce part of the country, yet we've got 20% of the planned growth for the country in that part of the country. The World Economic Forum, a few weeks ago, identified in the top risks, water scarcity, the competition for water around the world, driven by growth, driven by economic development, as well as the threats of floods and drought, you know, three of the highest risks that they identified. So as a water task force, we got together and thought, well, what can we do about that? Because there's a real impact. You know, the floods we're seeing at the moment, potentially £500 million impact on the economy. In 2007, the floods caused £3 billion worth of impact on our UK economy. Yet you can also flick to the other side of impact on water and think about the fact that in some of the climate change scenarios, we're anticipating 75, 76 droughts once every 10 years. The south of England, southeast of England, is already water scarce, and yet that is where we're going to have most of the growth. So what do we do about that as businesses? And we've identified really three sort of areas we can look at. The first one relates to what we do in terms of using the natural environment. And I think this is almost de-greenwellying it, taking the green wellies out of it and saying, no, business has to have a view about how we can work with the natural environment to improve our relationship with water and make it much more sustainable. So, for example, what we can do in catchment, this is what we saw on the Seeing is Believing trip, what we can do in catchments to improve drinking water quality without having to build lots of concrete and lots of steel. So how we can work with the environment and work and collaborate upstream to sort the problems out rather than sorting them out downstream. Similarly, in terms of flooding, what we can do to manage surface water flooding using natural systems. These are things that sometimes people with green wellies talk about. Businesses need to talk about it, otherwise we won't get to the solution. So can we get examples up there and lift those up, raise the profile? So that's one. Second one, more straightforward, it appears on the face of it, but how can we use less of the product we supply, particularly as water businesses? It's very, very important in water scarce areas we use less of it. So what can we do to actually help businesses, communities, customers use less of the product? It'll help us to avoid blocking growth moving forward, which is terribly important. And the third one is about resilience. What we can do as individual companies and with our supply chains and with communities to be more resilient to these more extreme weather events, which are becoming the new norm. And we feel there's an awful lot we can do from fairly straightforward sort of toolkits that we can provide in terms of resilience, right the way through to thinking about how all our supply chains are interconnected and how we might be able to work together to be just that bit more resilient to the climate change impacts that we see today. So it makes a lot of sense for us as a business, and we're definitely up for it.
Well, Peter, thank you for that, and thank you for your leadership.